So these are my acrylic supplies slash gesso and some acrylic gouaches, and I'm going through this now. These are these things that you use for stretching canvas if they like unstretched, so I will definitely keep those. My sandpaper, because I like really smooth surface to work on, so I sometimes like sand down my, well, do gesso and sanding faces, so I need different grade of sandpaper. Definitely all of these are keeps because they are, well, tools and any tools. And here is Core Watercolor Crown. Focus on this one. And actually, I bought this one because I wanted to use watercolors on canvas. But I tried this and I didn't like the results that much. Actually, I don't like how this how the watercolors behave on this surface. It wasn't like on the paper, it was really easy to lift off and it just didn't work out. But I noticed that it made cool background. Actually, I can show it because it's here. It made like really cool background, like with watercolor effect. So I think I will keep this if I want to do like watercolor background and like washes on the top or something like that. Or do different kind of technique with watercolor. My gouache. This is this huge gouache primer. Oil and acrylic. Works great. I have used this quite much. It's just cheap. It's just a job. Definitely keep. Well, then we have a little bit. We have my acrylic. Well, actually, this is Sinhan Past Hybrid Color in Linden Green. It's my test tube, and I haven't yet decided will I want these colors, or will I want the normal gouaches, or will I like don't want the gouaches at all. So, this is like a test tube, and it actually brings me joy because it's green. That's really funny, like I have the color brings me joy. And then I have my new tubes of gouaches. And these are green, pastel green, which actually bring me joy. Hot pink, coral red, which actually don't think bring me any joy, so I think I will toss it. Joan Brilliant, some like permanent yellow green, luminous lemon. Green. These actually are quite one of my favorite colors, and this is like skin color. So definitely keep these. And greens bring me joy. And then I have somewhere this horrible plastic bristly brush that I will throw away because it brings painful memories from childhood. And these are my Japanese square colors for tuner acrylics. And actually, I enjoy these quite much, so I will definitely keep these ones. Oh, here's one of my paintings that I made with gouache. Keep, because I want to keep my old paintings too. And one puppet. Keep. And here you can see my gouache set from bottom. But I will keep it. It has some nice brushes, some nice gouaches. And it has like palette on the top. It's actually quite compact for its size, so definitely keeping those ones. I'm actually really enjoying those gouaches, acrylic gouaches. Oh, here are a round like MDF board that I will use as painting surface, surface and test how this will work. Well, now we are on my acrylics. Actually, I have acrylics. I haven't been doing any like talking about them that much, but I have them. But first, I have a gloss varnish and wood primer for my acrylic gouaches. Definitely keep retarder that slows the drying time. Definitely keep. This was actually awesome thing. It's worked really great. These two, even these are like bright yellow and blue, it actually weren't opaque enough, so I'm not keeping these ones, I have better ones. And here I have some kind of gloss varnish. It says it's, I'm not sure actually what this is, but I'm not using this because I have other things that I use for varnish. This one is my acrylic medium, gloss medium. And if you have watched my videos, you have noticed that I use this for like fixing my graphite drawings. So definitely keep one, keep this one because I use this quite often. And then I have a Gambar picture varnish. And I use this for varnishing my oil paintings. And this one is my Camsol bottle. I have a smaller container where I keep my Camsol, but this is like the bottle that I use. Definitely keep, I use it when I do watercolor work. Gold Gallery acrylic gloss varnish. I really use this, and I actually use this quite much when I'm using acrylic work. Even if I have the Gambar picture varnish, I still think I will use that with. I have, I'm not sure what this is in English, because it says on here only Finnish and in Russia. But this is like oil color solvent, that's like, it's tarpatti in Finnish. I'm not sure what this is in English. Something. It's definitely not odorless mineral spirit. Maybe like mineral spirit because they smell horrible. But actually I don't use this, but I sometimes use this when I use like enamel paint on like those little plastic models. So sometimes really useful when you need like clean some blister brushes. And this is fast drying medium for water mixed by oil color from Winsor & Newton, because I have a Stahls and Rembrandt color and they don't have this medium by Tayline, so I try this artisan version. If this doesn't work, I will use liquid. But I want to use something that is like cleanable with water. More of those stretcher things. And here you can see my acrylic pile. I have some Mimeri polycolor that's like in a nice plastic bottle. Some other Mimeri polycolors because my local art supply store sells Mimeri colors. Well, only polycolors and oil colors, but not like the watercolors, which is really sad. Some my other acrylics are graduate from Dollar and Rona. I use this when I got like some painting things to do, but not that often. But still, I think I will keep these because I have tested out these are all in great working condition, and I sometimes want to try out oil over acrylics, so then I need my acrylics. And these are actually my well, I use this for opening my stacked jeans. And for acrylic palettes, I use these glasses that are from some picture frames. They are easier to clean up. And so, next one is my paper things and some random papers.